You're gonna get drunk.
You want me to go on stage?
Back there.
You come to get half of
it. Take it.
Pussy.
Come on, take it.
Look how small you are, you little midget!
Hey! You the one was on the ground. I was standing on top of you.
And you're gonna be on the floor this time, ain't ya?
You ever heard of David and Goliath?
Yeah.
You know that story of what happened? It is gonna happen to you.
Yeah, but the thing is,
you don't believe in David and Goliath.
Best amateur, maybe greatest boxer in the history of the United States, Mark Breland, gold medalist, 110 fights in amateurs, 100 knockouts. You also work very closely with Deontay Wilder, along with Jay Diesel, of course. Tell me, how was camp for Fury for the rematch?
My camp was good, you know, we went through everything, and throwing good punches. He's in great shape.
I just asked Tyson Fury's coach, what's your prediction? He said what everyone is saying. What is everyone telling you?
Deontay's gonna knock him out.
What round?
I came about 7
rounds. You know boxing. You're a boxing mind. Why do you say Wilder right now? What is it that you see?
I mean, you know, if you look at the history of boxing, normally when you fight a guy, you knock him out the first fight, and then you fight again. Well, he's thinking about it. He's thinking about it, and the way he got hit and how he got hit. Oh, he's thinking about it. He's going to be gunshots. And he'll come out. He'll try to do the, you know, he's very, you know,
we wanted the rematch.
Clowning around and doing all kind of stuff. But he's good at mind games. And that's his whole thing. He's trying to do different things. But once you get hit,
like I said,
a good hit will change your mind.
That's true. Now, Fury says he's going to bring it to Wilder. Do you believe him that he's going to come balls out swinging?
Well, he says he's 270. He's coming in at 270. That's not going to make you a big puncher. You know, that's going to put more weight on you. My thing, you know, just box. Now, if you want to do that, Deontay hit harder than you. He hits harder than he is. Who's going to get there first? And if he's going to run it, if he's going to come and walk him down, he's going to run into something.
Deontay Wilder fans are watching. What do you tell them? Mark Breland.
Watch for the knockout.
There you have it. Mark Breland said, 7th round. You don't want to miss it. Deontay Wilder, Tyson Fury rematch. You can order the pay-per-view on Fox. FaceNewsReport.com and Basic Back reporting. I'm talking to Jay. He's one of the best coaches in boxing. Took Deontay Wilder from no knowledge in boxing to one of the best, if not the best, heavyweight in history. How was camp for this Fury rematch?
Oh, I mean, camp's been great. We're excited. And I will say, Deontay, he came into the gym on day one with a purpose. And so I'd love to take credit, but the credit goes to him.
I'm picking Wilder by knockout. Some people are saying Fury by knockout. I just can't vision it. What do you see? How do you see the fight unfolding?
I mean, I think obviously Deontay's going to win the fight. I don't think he's going to do so in spectacular fashion, but I'm not one to call rounds. I think that's okay for the fighters to do because they're in the ring. I'm not in the ring, so I'm not one to say this round or that round or whatever. I just don't like it when trainers do that. That's just a personal thing.
Obviously, you're hearing a lot of the rhetoric, the Fury saying how he's preparing, the hands in gasoline, the other activities. What do you make of that?
I mean, he's a charismatic guy, and he's a funny guy. And whatever he's doing, he's doing. So we don't really concern ourselves with what he's doing. We're just concerned with what we do. So, you know, usually in boxing, if you do what you do better than they do what they do, you're going to come out on top. So that's what we're looking to do.
Andy Ruiz and Manny Robles were a good team. They split. Everyone's going their way. I get along with both of them great. Would you be open to coaching Andy Ruiz if he approached you?
No, I'm with Deontay. You know, and that's the only thing that I'm interested in. I think Andy's a great fighter, and he's got a tremendous past, present, and a tremendous future as well. And he'll find the right guy. I think you did a great job. The coach he had did a great job.
Andy Robles, yeah.
So you know, but they know the inside story, and I don't. So it's not fair for me to comment. But he's a great fighter, and he'll find the right guy. It's just, you know, I'm all immersed with Deontay, and there's nothing else that you know, that I want on my plate than doing what I do.
How would Andy do with King Kong? You guys faced King Kong twice. You obviously know Andy Ruiz.
It's a really good, it's a really interesting fight, and I hope it happens, because nobody has ever wanted to face Ortiz except for Deontay Wilder. So that would be fantastic if Andy Ruiz says, you know, I want some of that too, you know? And I think that would be a very entertaining fight.
I interviewed Chris Bird, who beat Klitschko, was a gold medalist, mm-hmm. and a lot of big accolades. He told me he would rather fight Mike Tyson than fight Deontay Wilder. He says, Wilder, you just don't know, that right hand is a game changer. What do you think?
Right, well, I didn't say I'm a huge Chris Bird fan, as far as he was a tremendous boxer. Chris was actually a better puncher than people give him credit for. They think he's small and that he couldn't punch, but in fact, you know, so why don't you run through it? You know, and nobody did. He hurt David Tua with an uppercut to the chest right here, and people don't remember that, and I do remember that. David Tua was somebody you basically couldn't hurt, so that tells you a lot about that. Chris, with the right shots, could hurt people, and you don't keep Vitaly and Vladimir off of you if you can't punch. So anyway, he never got to do his just due, but Chris Bird was a tremendous fighter. But anyway, aside from that, that was interesting of him to say that about Deontay.
All right, Coach, thank you so much. Good luck. We'll see how it happens. Today they're going to face off, and there you have it. JD's one of the best in the business. For your superpoint.com, I'll see back reporting. Thank you. Mauricio,
how are you?
We're here with the champ.
Look at him.
It's a big fight.
Big fight, and he's ready. He's excited.
What's up, Molly? I'm good. How are you?
Okay. You just got here.
Just got it. Okay, yeah. Odds makers originally had one step at a time. Look, I just drove in. Now the favorites. I want to know your thoughts on that.
No, I really don't. So they get into the odds and different things.
21
years old.
Monster.
Doing the herky jerky. Can't lose. Monster.
The best thing
I can do as an athlete, as the one that I don't mean, I'm performing to perform to the best of my ability, to do what I know what to do. And those that are expressing their opinions and betting on them, hopefully they make the right decision.
Well, 66% of the money's coming on you now. I mean, according to the odds makers at Bet Online, money's been coming around you, in addition to you being the favorite with knockout for every round. Thank you. You're the favorite right now.
Nice. Well, all that's betting on me, they made the right decision. They're not going to go home sad, that's for sure.
All right, champ. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Blessings.
All right. All right. He's got to use the bathroom first.
Hey, Joe, good to see you again, man. How you been?
Good to see you. How are you?
You hanging in there?
Fine.
Yeah?
Yeah. It's okay.
All right. Let's get this show on the road.
Yeah.
Where you're coming back in?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mauricio, it's a huge fight. We're excited. We're here, Wilder Fury.
It's a rematch. It's a record setting of the tallest ever in a ring between them two. So it's sensational.
You can feel the excitement in the air.
You can feel the excitement.
All right. I'll go back in a few minutes. Thank you.
Okay. Thanks.
Then you will have your final comments of the final press conference.
Like I said, it's the final countdown right here. You know, you can see that we're emotionally invested in this. We want to give you guys the best of us. Come Saturday night, we're going to release all our negative energy in the ring, and it's going to stay there. You know, after the fight, you know, we're going to be able to come together and give each other hugs and tell what great job we've done. You know, right now, you know, it's time. And this is the moment we all been waiting for. This is the moment I've been waiting for. I'm sure it's the moment he's been waiting for as well. To have so many people, so many eyes looking in, to put the heavyweight division on notice. And it's been throughout these last few years, it's been tremendous of what's been going on. And as our first fight, as y'all can see, you know, it was amazing. We lit it up, and this time around, it won't be no different. You know, I think it'll be even more intense fight this time around. We know each other a little bit more better, and what more do you want for us, from us, you know, to give our all, and that's what we're gonna do for you guys come Saturday night. I'm looking forward to it. I can't wait for it, and that's it, baby.
We all can't wait for it. Undefeated heavyweight champions meeting up. This is what the sport should always be at its very best. And give credit to the two of you for making that happen. Yes,
Chief. One last thing, I'd like to thank everyone that's been involved with this, you know, the networks, the promotion, the promoters, the managers, because with fights like this, it's hard to come by, you know, especially nowadays, you know, we always say the best should fight the best, and sometimes that always can't happen. It takes build up, it takes a certain point in time for that to happen, but this is something that's never been done before. These are two networks, the two biggest networks in sports, Fox and ESPN, and we got, you know, Al Heyman, we got, you know, everybody that's involved. There's so many names to name. There's so many people, and everyone that knows who's involved, man, I just appreciate you from the bottom of my heart to get this fight going, and here we go, guys. I can't wait.
Great credit to PBC and Fox, to the Hall of Fame promoter Bob Arum and Top Rank and ESPN. Guys, you brought it in for a nice, calm landing. That was easy. Well done. Champ, good to be with you. Champ, good to be with you. Kate, take it away. We survived somehow. It's all you.
Back and forth between the two initially about who had made this a bigger fight. Doesn't really matter in the end because we're all winning in this one. Tim, what are your thoughts on what we've just seen? It feels like a pressure cooker. There is so much on the line with these guys.
They pretty much said it all, but I just want to just put this out there. Like, I need to let everybody know that the whole
favorite device. You can also go to ESPNplus.com/WilderFury, click buy now, or watch it on the ESPN app. Go to the ESPN Plus tab, click on Wilder Fury fight tile, also available on pay-per-view. Joe Tessitore sandwiched between Deontay Wilder and Tyson Fury. It has been a fascinating and I think now people motivated very much here to see what happens on Saturday night past hour of a visit with two of you. I thank you for that. I thank you for engaging in such a thoughtful conversation after all the vitriol that we had early on here. But now I have a sense that it could be bubbling up again as I will offer each of you the...
So what was it like to be on stage the whole time?
Just so great.
Hey. It was cool? A little tense up there? So if you want to watch the Wilder Fury 2 pay-per-view on Fox, click on the link right below in the info box. Pay-per-view on Fox, Wilder Fury. Don't miss it. Deontay Wilder, knockout artist, one of the best heavyweights in history of boxing, back in the ring versus Fury. Check it out.